As Thanksgiving approaches, UMD students are scrambling to get tested before heading home. I'll have more details coming up.
If you've been unemployed due to COVID-19, Prince George's County is looking for many ways to fill your pockets this holiday.
With Thanksgiving coming up, make sure you know some helpful tips on how to keep your pets safe.
COVID numbers we haven't seen before, and one at-risk group working to get a life-saving message out. I'm Zach Solon.
Hey, museum goers heading to D.C. will have to make new plans. I'm Morgan Weaver, and this is CNS TV.
COVID-19 case numbers are hitting record highs in Maryland. And with Thanksgiving approaching, students at the University of Maryland have been scrambling to get tested before leaving the area and heading home to their families.
So I'm going back home to Philly. That's why I got my testing done today in preparation for it.
Thanksgiving is approaching, and UMD students are making sure they get tested for COVID before heading home.
I think everyone's worried about it. Like, it's just something that's scary, but, you know, it's the world we live in now, so we just have to, like, do what we have to do.
But with cases rising and many planning to leave the state, some students are worried about getting tested in time to get results.
It was really, honestly, hard the first couple of times to, like, feel like I could even get a test because, like, they weren't offering. This was, like, when it was mandatory, like, they were, like, sign up for this time. It was, like, hard to get a test.
So right now what I'm trying to do is just push the school to make more testing appointments available. In preparation for Thanksgiving, they did make more testing dates available.
This heightened testing comes as the state of Maryland today reported 2,910 new cases, the most in a single day since the pandemic began. Last week, UMD reported 50 new cases from university testing alone.
But while some students think the university is doing its best,
I feel like it's a really efficient process. This time it took me like 10 minutes, and I was like really late for my appointment, so they've been like on top of it.
Others remain skeptical about what happens after the holiday.
The university is still choosing to shut down quarantine housing as of December 8th. As of right now, they've also made no attempt to make any more testing appointments available for students who remain here.
UMD has not announced plans to conduct other on-campus tests till December 1st, leaving some students to wonder if they should return to College Park after seeing their families next week.
I've seen people being probably less safe as the semester's gone on, so probably should get tested more often than not.
I am planning on coming back, and I'd actually like to come back before winter break is over. And I would only do that if I think that the campus community is going to be promoting the safety that they say that they're promoting.
The university is not requiring students to return to campus after Thanksgiving break, since all classes will be remote for the remainder of the semester. The university has not announced policies and testing plans for spring semester.
As testing becomes harder to come by and as cases rise, contact tracers have struggled to pinpoint coronavirus outbreaks. To help combat the spread, the Maryland COVID Alert System was launched last week. Today, Governor Larry Hogan announced more than 1 million Marylanders have opted into the COVID-19 exposure notification system. The system uses Bluetooth technology to notify somebody if they have been exposed. Users who receive an alert are advised to get tested, monitor their health, and quarantine. Exposure is of top mind for nurses in D.C. schools who say they are not ready for in-person classes, and they took their message to the mayor's home. CNS TV's Scott Shapiro joins us in the studio with details. Scott?
Thanks, Morgan. The D.C. Nurses Association says schools are not ready for nurses to return for in-person classes, even though those classes started yesterday. They say they have serious concerns about whether they will be protected.
Thank you for standing up for our children.
We're trying to let the leaders in our city know that we're important, and what we have to say is important, and we're the workers out there.
DC nurses protested outside the mayor's home this weekend. They are doing this as in-person classes began yesterday in some public schools.
School started yesterday, and there are people who have still not been fitted for N95 masks.
The D.C. Nurses Association says it is unhappy with the procedures put in place to keep them safe.
Nurses have not really received all of the PPE that's necessary. They are being fitted for N95 masks a week before.
Part of the problem is that the D.C. Nurses Association does not have a uniform policy in place. There is no policy that details what items belong on a list of personal protective equipment or PPE. Nor is there a policy detailing COVID monitoring and testing procedures. Nurses have different ideas of what should happen. The DCNA says it is working now to standardize a PPE list and policies so that schools can be prepared to meet their concerns.
So we're going to keep pushing.
Another part of the disconnect may be that nurses are working with a number of organizations, and because they are, communication right now is not streamlined.
We're working with Children's School Services, they're our managers. Then we're working with DCPS. Then we're working with DC Health. And those people can't seem to get it together.
We have reached out to DC Health and DC Public Schools to comment on the story, but so far have been unable to get a statement. The urgency for nurses is that starting in-person classes is on a rolling schedule that continues through January. They say it is important to have standards in place now as these classes begin. Zach, Morgan.
The busiest travel holiday of the year or not? Mid-Atlantic AAA says most of you will be hunkering down for Turkey Day. COVID concerns are the biggest reason 90% of Marylanders say they'll skip planes, trains, and automobiles this year. The rest of the DMV is planning to be almost as homebound. 83% of folks in the district are saying they'll stay home, while 84% of Virginians say the same.
Many of those people staying home in Prince George's County are looking at holidays with no means to celebrate with family. The pandemic has hit them in a different way. They've lost their jobs, but help is on the way. CNS TV's Yamari Cisse joins us in the studio with details. Yamari?
Unemployment numbers spiked in Prince George's County in September. Businesses and workers are struggling, but as of today, $500,000 are available to ease that pandemic pain.
Our goal is to help that unemployed worker who just got laid off and out of the blue. I mean, honestly, we're just trying to help everybody that we can.
And it's a big task here in Prince George's County, which ties Baltimore City for the state's highest unemployment rate, 9.1% in September. The October figures are due out tomorrow. The county's workforce intelligence company is looking to get residents employed this holiday. How? By making available a total of $500,000 to businesses that hire unemployed residents before December 15th.
If we can continue that growth and continue, it's small and it's incremental, but as long as, you know, if every month we can chomp at that unemployment rate.
Here's how it works. Each business can receive a maximum of $50,000 to supplement 50 to 90% of the new hire salary for the first 12 weeks.
So how can we encourage them to hire Prince George County residents, but also how can we provide some financial incentives to businesses?
The county is also providing a one-time relief payment of $300 to residents who are unemployed or whose wages were reduced because of the pandemic.
You know, as a mother, I felt for her that she can't have a birthday party for her child because she had to choose between her phone bill or birthday cake, and of course she needed her phone. She has that money. That not only can she pay for some other things, she can pay for her children to have a birthday party.
Businesses can apply for the Rapid Reemployment Grant at employpg.org.
I'm telling people, it's your money. You just have to apply. You know, come get your money.
The deadline for the Reemployment Relief Program for businesses and the $300 Employee Relief Fund is December 15th, just in time for the holiday. Back to you, Zach.
Rising COVID cases across the DMV are forcing the hands of one popular tourist attraction. The Smithsonian announced today that museums that reopened across the region would close again beginning Monday, November 23rd. The museum said this decision was made out of an abundance of caution and in response to surging COVID cases, saying, quote, "We will use this time to reassess, monitor, and explore additional risk mitigation measures."
And although the National Zoo is closing, along with other museums, you still have time to join in on the Smithsonian's most important vote of the year. The zoo's three-month-old panda cub needs a name, and the zoo is asking for your help in making that decision. Voters can visit the zoo's website and cast a vote through Friday, November 20th. The final vote will be announced Monday, November 23rd.
Seeing an unknown number pop up on your phone is nothing new.
But that number could be a scam. Coming up, we'll show you what one group is doing to help those affected and what you can do to protect yourself from scammers.
Roll over. Chance high five. All right.
When you adopt a shelter pet, you discover all the things that make them unique.
And your mother and...
I am totally a hot person. Right, guys? Thanks for being honest.
They're a little bit of a lot of things, but they're all pure love. Adopt pure love at theshelterpetproject.org.
Got it!
Hi.
Can you help me?
I got it.
Thank you.
No problem.
Just like the rules to surviving Zombieland, there are steps you can take to be prepared for an emergency.
It's the right thing to do.
Talk with your family to make a plan. Look for safe areas to meet up if separated. And stock up on supplies. It's never too early to get prepared. So start now.
Right now?
Right now. You can't predict emergencies, but you can be ready.
You're welcome, America.
Visit ready.gov today to learn more.
Hi, everyone. Al Roker here. As a guy with his own catchphrase, I appreciate that after 75 years, Smokey's only said,
"Only you can prevent wildfires."
But I'm filling in because there's a lot more to report. Like when there are parched or windy conditions out there, you gotta be extra careful with things like burning yard waste. After all, wildfires can start anywhere, even in your neck of the woods. Go to SmokeyBear.com to learn more about wildfire prevention.
Here you go.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Welcome back to CNS TV. No charges tonight in the controversial police shooting of a DC teen. The U.S. Attorney's Office announced it won't pursue federal criminal civil rights charges against the Metropolitan Police Department. 18-year-old Dion Kay was shot and killed September 2nd. Police body cam video showed Kay with a gun in his hand. Prosecutors say the video and witness statements led to their decision not to bring charges against the officer involved.
Breaking hearts could cost two Gaithersburg brothers their freedom. David and Leslie Anna are accused of bilking $5 million from 200 victims online. The pair is charged with developing romances with people ranging from 38 to 83 through dating websites and social media. Allegedly, the brothers scammed the money using promises of travel and in-person dates.
Now, it may be easy to understand how your emotions can lead to being scammed. After all, we're used to being told you can't put a price on love. But what's love got to do with it? Each year, thousands of people are scammed over some basic things, and they don't even know it. India Freye joins us with more. India?
Thanks, Zach. These scams happen in the form of robocalls. They're annoying, they're incessant, it seems, and all too often, they seem believable.
They tell you your car warranty is expired. You've missed a bill payment, and the IRS is looking for you. Typically, these are scam calls, also known as robocalls. And because there are thousands of calls a day, it keeps one customer protection group busy.
People, you know, unfortunately, are, especially now during the COVID time period, are really abusing it especially and kind of preying on everyone.
Utilities United Against Scams helps scores of people like Princess Green, whose grandmother was a victim of a scam.
It's real because it hit home for me.
The scammers told Green's grandmother that they would shut off her electricity unless she paid with a prepaid card.
She couldn't understand why they would want to do that to her.
Scammers are getting savvier each day, learning how to mask themselves using real company names to fool people.
Our employees will never, ever demand a payment, ask you to do an immediate payment on the spot with a prepaid cash card, or ask for your account number or other personal information. So that is a red flag. Do not give out that information.
The Office of the Attorney General got 46,000 complaints about frauds last year. In fact, during my interview with her, we were interrupted by a robocall.
So what just popped up was potential scam on my cell phone. Many attorney generals have been working with the phone companies, trying to get them to do more things to try and make it so that people can recognize that something might be a scam.
The number one thing you can do to protect yourself from phone scammers is to verify. If you're unsure if the call is real, hang up and call the number that the company gave you on a previous bill. Back to you, Morgan.
Coming up, one former Maryland basketball player's future is shaping out to be a great one following last night's announcement.
But first, COVID's impact on the Maryland football team continues to spread. Stay with us.
Do you...
Listen, you're my friend.
I noticed you haven't really been yourself recently.
Yeah, I feel like something's up.
How are you?
Are you okay?
Is there anything you want to talk about?
I just want to know how you're feeling.
And listen, even if you don't know what to say, I'm here to talk.
No matter what you're going through,
I just want you to know I'm here.
I've got your back. When you want to talk, I'm here.
They call me Prince like I'm royalty or something. But the places I've lived ain't no palaces. So I don't need grilled salmon or a new scratching post. Just give me a cardboard box and a can of tuna and we're good. You can even change my name. I'm cool being the kitty formerly known as Prince.
Hi, I'm your host, Smokey Colbert. Filling in for Smokey, because after 75 years of...
Only you can prevent wildfires.
Turns out there's much more to say. Nearly 90% of wildfires are caused by us humans being careless, dumping our used barbecue coals willy-nilly. Guess the song was wrong. We did start the fire. That's why I respect Mother Nature and her trees, whether coniferous or new car scented. Go to SmokeyBear.com to learn more about wildfire prevention.
Big news in sports today, a new report of a COVID positive case in Maryland athletics, this time head coach Mike Locksley. While Maryland took steps to isolate last week following 8 positive tests, canceling all in-person team activities and relocating to the hotel in College Park, cases have continued to increase. Head coach Mike Locksley is one of 7 staffers to test positive over the past week, as have an additional 15 players. For a population positivity rate of 14.9%, they are all in isolation.
Obviously, I feel very strong and healthy as we work through it. Did I have some minor symptoms? Sure. Whether it was a small cough, a runny nose, those type of things, as Dr. Rooks alluded to, very similar to the common cold. Once I got it on Monday night, I reported it to Dr. Rooks, and we went from there.
In a press conference not long ago, University Health Center Dr. Yvette Rooks says that everyone is doing well and is experiencing mild symptoms. For the second consecutive week, Maryland football won't be in action Saturday. The Terps game against Michigan State has been canceled as the program continues to deal with coronavirus outbreak. The Terps were 2-1 before their game against Ohio State last week. Since neither game will be rescheduled, the team only has 3 remaining games against Indiana, Michigan, and Rutgers. After carving out an All-American career in high school and in college, Jalen Smith is Maryland's latest NBA draft pick. The former Mount St. Joseph and Maryland star was drafted number 10 overall by the Phoenix Suns on Wednesday night, becoming the Terps' 3rd draft pick in 3 years and the program's 6th since 2016. After being pushed back several months due to COVID-19, the draft finally arrived Wednesday night. Baltimore native and University of Maryland standout, Jalen Smith found himself a new home.
With the 10th pick in the 2020 NBA Draft, the Phoenix Suns select Jalen Smith from the University of Maryland.
Smith is the highest Terps draft pick since Alex Len, who was taken 5th overall in 2015 by the Suns.
Obviously, extremely happy for Jalen. He's such a great kid. He was such a fun young man to coach for 2 years. They had the guts to pick him at 10, and so they obviously have a plan for him. I think he's going to, have a chance to really make an impact right away.
Smith only spent 2 seasons in College Park, leading the Terps to the 2019-2020 Big Ten regular season title. The 6'10", 225-pound forward averaged 15.5 points, 10.5 rebounds as a sophomore, and earned third-team All-American honors. He was projected to go anywhere from 13th overall to towards the end of the first round, but instead he cemented himself as a top 10 pick. But no matter where he landed, his fellow Terps are proud of him.
I know this has been a dream for him for a long time. I'm proud. He put in all the work to get to where he's at. So I'm excited for him, excited to see where his future takes him.
The 20-year-old Baltimore native will join a team on the rise in the Western Conference, with Phoenix recently trading for 10-time All-Star guard Chris Paul to pair with young stars Devin Booker and DeAndre Ayton.
Morgan, I'll tell you, when I found out Jalen Smith got drafted last night, I pretty much jumped out of my chair. Watching him play at Maryland the past 2 years, had a chance to cover him, too. He's a stand-up guy, works really hard. He's really well-deserving. I was really happy for him.
Very well-deserving.
Absolutely. We're just a week away from Thanksgiving, and many of us will be spending some quality time at home with pets.
Coming up, find out how you can help your furry friends have a fun and safe Turkey Day.
Each year, there are more than a dozen significant tropical and winter storms that threaten the East Coast. So chances are there will be more hurricanes and blizzards near here again. And between school, sports, and social lives, chances are you won't be with your kids when it happens. Will they know what to do? Ready.gov/kids has all the educational tools and information to make the conversation easy. When the time comes, chances are they'll feel prepared, not scared. So talk with your family today.
I'll never forget the day our landlord called and said, read your lease. No pets allowed. My owner tells him my dog ate the lease, but that didn't work. And now I'm stuck in a shelter, but this pit bull is ready for a new crib. I'm loving, loyal, and play well with others. So don't be intimidated by all my muscles, because the biggest one I have is my heart. That's right, I said it.
Honorary Forest Ranger Betty White here, lending a hand to my dear friend Smokey Bear. Because for 75 years, he's only said,
only you can prevent wildfires.
But there's a lot more to say. Like, if you park your car on tall, dry grass, the hot exhaust pipe can start a wildfire. So keep the animals safe, especially the cute shirtless one. Go to SmokeyBear.com to learn more about wildfire prevention.
I'm starving. What's for breakfast?
Guten Tag!
Johannes Rums!
I bring you arts and rich Traisenblums, fortified with increased test scores and creative problem-solving skills.
It's good!
And good for you.
Bobby? Susie?
Don't worry, that's just the power of the arts!
Feed your kids the arts. For 10 simple ways to learn how, visit AmericansForTheArts.org.
With Thanksgiving 1 week from today, you're probably starting to focus on the turkey already.
But if you have pets, you should probably pay attention to them and some more. This week, CNS Melissa Signorini explains.
Excited for Thanksgiving food? Someone else is too, your furry friends. While you may have turkey on your mind, your pets are waiting for your tasty leftovers, and that could be dangerous.
Particularly at Thanksgiving, we're using a lot of rich and fatty foods that might be new or unfamiliar. And an abundance of them, if the dog or the cat eats too much, can cause pancreatitis, which can be life-threatening.
Feeding pets bones can also threaten or kill them.
So poultry or ham bones, they can splinter if given to a pet, and that could cause big issues in the gut and also be deadly.
If you're having guests over, be sure to let them know about your rules regarding pets.
So if you don't want your pet to be fed, make sure that you share that information with everyone who will be in your home.
With COVID restricting large gatherings, pet owner Lauren Lentini thinks keeping her dog safe won't be hard.
During COVID, I'm not having a lot of people over at my house, just my immediate family. So it shouldn't be too hectic and crowded.
There are other ways to protect your pets.
Make sure that anything loose that a pet could get to is out of the way. You know, there are.
It's not only food that can be a danger. Look out for plastic wrappings and dispose of them before your pets get to it. Reporting from College Park, I'm Melissa Signorini, CNS TV News.
Be sure to keep your local vet clinic's potential COVID restrictions and limited hours in mind this holiday season. Now, after watching that, I thought about my little dog right away, who's underneath her table begging for food at all times.
I don't have any pets. My aunt always brings her Great Dane on Thanksgiving, and it is awesome. Make sure you check us out online at cnsmaryland.org and follow us on Twitter at CNSMD.
You can find us on Facebook.com/MarylandCNS and on YouTube at CNS Maryland.
Thank you for joining us. Have a great weekend. We'll be right back.